Good morning, friends. As usual, today we are going to discuss about some of the business news which are related to some banking and which will be helpful for our IIBF certification exams. And we also know that some of JAB, CAB, IIBF exams have been postponed, so we have a lot of time for the preparation. It's a good thing, but don't get relaxed. So keep preparing. We don't know when the time will be tough, so keeping that in mind, we have to continue our preparation. So let's get into the discussion of important things with respect to the business. So as far as COVID-19 is concerned, it is creating it is showing its impact on all the sectors, and here is one of the sector that is by name construction sector. So usually there will be some good construction works will be happened in the month of in this quarter, that is January, February, March. But due to the happening of this COVID-19, there is a great fall in the housing sector, there is 41-42%. This quarter. So because of this COVID-19, the construction sector has come to halt, and there is no material supply has been stopped. And moreover, the subcontractors are unable to provide the resources for the construction activities. And moreover, the revenue which is coming for the construction, that means builders, is also getting down. And it will be, as per and moreover, they were estimating that there will be a great loss because of this COVID-19. And with hopefulness, if all the things get resumed by April end, it will take at least 7 to 8 months to return to the normal position. This was the estimation they are thinking. This is the estimation that they are thinking. So if all the things are get resumed by April end, this is this month end, all the things will get settled within 7 to 8 months if everything goes in a good way. So this is what the construction sector is facing in the outside world. And one more news here, center wants to borrow about 4.88 lakh crore in the first half. So center was decided to borrow 4.88 lakh crore in the first half. So the reason is, first, to fight the COVID-19. So what are all the requirements for requirements that are needed to fight the COVID-19, and also to protect the economy? So to help in these two factors, it decided to borrow 4.88 lakh crore. So in this financial year, 4.8 lakh will be borrowed with center, that is, and that too, as I told, that for fighting COVID-19 and also the protecting the economy. So in these two factors, center is going for borrowing, told by the economic department of economic affairs secretary Atan Chakrabarty. So he says that this is the requirement, and the center proposes to revise its ways and means advances limit to 1.2 lakh crore. Previously it was 75,000. Now it has been raised to 1.2 lakh crores, and during this quarter, it is going to plan the weekly borrowing of about 25,000 crore in the first quarter, with a net borrowing of 1,37,090 crore in the first quarter, out of 4.8 lakh in the first quarter. This is the amount which is going to be borrowed by the center. So for fighting this COVID-19 and keeping economy safe. So we have one more news. As we know that RBI has given some moratorium facilities to all the banks, so it can be used. So as a part of that, these are the two banks, IDBA Bank and IDFC Bank. These are going to implement the moratorium. So the borrower who are willing to go for more than can come can send a that means this bank has given a facility for the customers who want to go for moratorium can send a mail to the mail which is provided by the respective banks. For IDBA bank, it is moratorium@idba.co.in. The lender can send in a communication. So, this kind of facility is given by the IDBA bank. And other things, and what are the loans which are considered under this moratorium will be in the housing loans, loan against the property, auto loans, education loans, and personal loans. And moreover, as we know that RBI has already had allowed the banks and financial institutions, including the non-financial bank institutions, companies to extend a 3-month moratorium period on EMI falling due between the March and May for all the term loans. So this is also applicable to the auto sector, home loan, personal loans, as well as the credit card outstandings. So there are some banks where if anybody pays the EMI for the March, they are going to reverse it to the customer if they opt for the moratorium. If the customer opt for the moratorium, before the announcement of moratorium, if the customer pays the EMI, so the bank is going to return their EMI back. So there are some banks which are following. So one more news: IndusInd Bank deposit base drop up to 11%. So because of this S Bank crisis, so the people who the customers of IndusInd Bank, the two bulk deposit people, are withdrawing their cash outside as they felt that it is not safe. Because of that, there will be low CASA ratio. So it makes the bank to not to depend upon the bulk deposits in future. So that was their estimations. And also RBI always says in every meeting that to the people, the who maintain deposits in the private sector banks is safe. So they keep on telling that, and also said not to take out of the deposit from the private sector banks because their deposits are safe in those banks. That was the confidence that RBI is trying to give to the public. And here one more news. So in line with all other banks, there are some other banks which are trying to reduce their lending rates. In that scenario, the Indian Bank in IOB, they reduced their lending rates by 75 basis points, that is which is effective from April 1, and IOB has repo link rate will be come down from 8 to 7.25%, that is 75 basis points reduced from 8 to 7.25%. And also MCLR is existing is 8.45 to 8.25, that will be effective from April 10. So these are the changes done by the Indian Bank and IOB, MCLR changes. So we'll have some other news. The SBI and HDFC and ICICI Bank active moratorium. I have seen in like IDFC Bank and IDBA Bank have started their moratorium. In the same way, the other banks like SBI, HDFC and ICICI Bank also activated their moratorium. So those who are interested to go for the moratorium, they can avail their such kind of option by sending a mail to the respective banks. As I told that here SBI also clarified that if the customer has already paid the EMI for the March, then the amount will be reversed. If the customer send in a request, interest shall continue to accrue on the outstanding portion of the term loan during the moratorium period. So those who have paid the EMI for the so and so March, so bank is going to return it and you can start the moratorium period for the customer. So one more news, and ICICI Bank reduce its savings rate of interest by 25 basis points. For the amount up to 50 lakhs, the rate of interest is 3.25% for the savings deposit, and if it is more than 50 lakhs, it is be 3.75%. So this rate of new rate of interest will become effective from April 19. And also they reduced term deposits. Term deposits by 50 basis points. If the deposits are less than 2 crores, the new rate will be effective from April 3. So now people, now the savings rate of interest are coming down 3.25% for less than 50 lakhs and 3.75% which is greater than 50 lakhs effective from April 9. And these are the news. Thank you. I hope everybody is preparing for the IIBF examinations. So have the external thing, external things which help you at least for one, at least 1%, or else it will be helpful for you to know what is happening outside. So keep studying. All the best.